Hello everyone, how you doing? It's Bill with the Vinylverse. I'm here to do the Jazz Vinyl Tag 2021. This was started by Chris over Tunes from the Man Cave. Great guy, Chris. Had the pleasure of meeting Chris back in June of 2019. Hope to do so again soon. In my next visit down to North Carolina. So Chris put together a list of 21 questions for Jazz Vinyl Tag 2021. Seen a ton of videos coming out for it. I've only been able to watch a handful, but I didn't want to wait any longer and wanted to get my response in to the Vinyl Tag, Jazz Vinyl Tag 2021. So I have the questions over here and I'm just going to get started here. First, Chris, thank you very much for putting this together. Great job to you. Looks like a lot of people are responding, and that's great. So let's hope it continues moving forward. I know you wanted to do that, so looking forward to it. So let's get started with the questions here. First, album that got you into jazz. So I started getting into jazz in about high school. I was big into the drums, and I got into jazz via prog rock. My favorite drummer, Bill Bruford. He put out in 1987, started his own jazz band called Earthworks. This is their first album. So kind of contemporary jazz, a little bit different where Bill plays both electronic and acoustic drums, sometimes together. And how the electronic drums work in this setting is the electronic drums are patched to be musical notes. So he plays rhythm, but it's kind of like rhythmic melody. So very, very cool. Got to see them live several years after that, early 90s, I think. But Bill Bruford, Earthworks, this is really what started me down the path of jazz. And this goes into the second question, which is the first jazz album you bought. So back when I bought it, it was on CD, much like that Earthworks CD, but it is this. Rich versus Rich. Battle of bands and drums between Buddy Rich and Max Rich. This came out in it was recorded in 1959. I'm not sure if it came out that year or not. But this was the first, being a drummer, heavily into drums, this was the first jazz album I bought. This is a very cool album. I hope to get it on vinyl at some point. What they did is they took Buddy Roach's band and they took Max Roach's band, both quintets at the time. Let's see, Buddy Rich quintet, Buddy Rich on drums, Willie Dennis on trombone, Phil Woods on alto sax, John Bunch on piano, and Phil Leshen on bass. Max Roach's quintet is Max Roach on drums, Tommy Turrentine on trumpet, Stanley Turrentine on tenor, sax, Julian Priester on trombone, and Bobby Boswell on bass. And what they did is they combined both bands all together. And I'm not sure who's in which channel, but I think Buddy Rich, him and his band are in the left channel. Max Roach and his band are in the right channel. And they play all the arrangements together, which is pretty cool. And the big one on here is Figure Eights, which is drum solo, kind of Rich and Roach going back and forth. So pretty cool stuff. First jazz album, but. Next question, record you own on Blue Note. So could have picked a whole bunch of them, but I went with Whistle Stop by Kenny Dorham. One of my favorite, jazz albums. It's pretty high up there for me. really big fan of Kenny Dorham, and I don't recall what year this came out. I don't recall, probably 60, 61 maybe. Yeah, but on here you have Hank Mobley on tenor sax, of course Kenny Dorham on trumpet, Kenny Drew on piano, Paul Chambers on bass, and Philly Joe Jones on drums. And so incredible lineup, great, great album. If you've never heard this one, highly, highly recommend. Okay, next question. Album or record you own on Prestige? Boss Tenor from Gene Ammons. So let's see, on here you have Gene Ammons on tenor sax, Tommy Flanagan on piano, Doug Watkins on bass, Art Taylor on drums, and Ray Barreto on conga. This came out in 1960, I believe. There's that Prestige Fireworks label. This is an original. Great album. Really enjoy it. Awesome cover too. Okay. Next question is record you own on Impulse. Well, let's start with Impulse A1, the great Kai and JJ. Featuring Bill Evans, Paul Chambers, Tommy Williams, Roy Haynes, and Art Taylor. So, brand new and swinging together. So, J.J. Johnson and Kai Winding, two great trombone players. So, yeah, another great album here. This is an original mono, in wonderful condition. There's the Impulse label. Okay, moving along. Next question. Record you own on Riverside. So I chose from 1962, the Cannonball Adderley Sextet in New York, featuring Nat Adderley and Yusef Lateef, recorded live at the Village Vanguard. Great album, another great lineup, 1962. This is a stereo copy. Maybe sure want to let you know it's stereo up top there. Julian Cannonball Adderley on alto sax, Nat Adderley on cornet, Yusef Lateef on tenor sax, flute, and oboe, Joe Zawinul on piano, Sam Jones on bass, and Lewis Hayes on drums, recorded January 12th and 14th, 1962. Another great album. So that is Riverside. Okay, now the next question shows something, a record you own on Contemporary. I thought I had something on Contemporary. Turns out I don't. So thanks to Dave over at Local Bandography. I mentioned this to him. He said just show something else on a different label. So I chose Pacific Jazz. And this is Chico Hamilton Quintet featuring Buddy Collette. I actually forget what year this came out. 1955, I think. Recorded August 4th, 1955. So on here, Buddy Collette on flute, clarinet, tenor, and alto. Jim Hall on guitar, Fred Katz on cello, Carson Smith on bass, and Chico Hamilton on drums. And this is a really good album on Pacific Jazz. So that's the Chico Hamilton Quintet featuring Buddy Collette. Okay, next question is record you own on subsidiary or small jazz label. Okay, so on Bethlehem, Here is Art Blakey Big Band. Art Blakey's Big Band, I should say. So this has a ton of players on it. But this was on Bethlehem, and this came out in 1960... Well, recorded in 1957, but I don't recall what year it came out. There is the Bethlehem label. Maybe it came out in 58. I don't think it came out in 57. So that's Bethlehem there. Next question. Record you own, not many know about, but should. Okay. This is Clifford Jordan and the Magic Triangle. On Stage Volume 1. There's actually a Volume 2 and Volume 3 that I want to get into the collection, because this Volume 1 is just so good. On here, this is on Steeplechase. On here you have Clifford Jordan on Clifford Jordan on tenor sax, Cedar Walton on piano, Sam Jones on bass, and Billy Higgins on drums. This was recorded in 1975. Yeah, and recorded live at the BIM house in Amsterdam, March 29th, 1975. And this is volume one out of three volumes. And this is just tremendous. Really, really great. You have a Wayne Shorter track on here, Pinocchio. A Cedar Walton track called The Maestro. But the final track, Mountain, by Clifford Jordan, 14 minutes long, and it is wonderful. And this is on Steeplechase. Okay, next question is, favorite jazz record bought in 2020? So I bought a lot in 2020. A lot of favorites, so I can't say which one is actually my favorite, but one that I was really, really stoked to get, and I'm still love the fact that I got this. This is Soul Stern by Benny Green on Blue Note. This originally came out in 1958, I think, but this is a Japanese pressing from 1983. And it is pretty much, other than a little corner ding down the bottom for the cover, the jacket mint, and the record is pretty much flawless. But I really love this album. So Benny Green on trombone. I mentioned Gene Ammons earlier. He's on here along with Billy Root, both playing tenor sax. Sonny Clark on piano, Ike Isaacs on bass, and the great Elvin Jones on drums. If you've never heard this album, look for it. Not an easy album to find, but just really wonderful. I wish they would reissue this one, either on like a Blue Note Classic series or one of the other labels like Music Matters. Or great record. Next question is, favorite record in an artist's discography? This was kind of a hard one. Actually, I was going to pick a different album, and then I was watching someone's video, Michael Muller at Noted and Archived. He showed the one that I was going to pick, and I'm going to be showing that album a little later on. So, I ended up going with, Great Jim Moncur III. With his album Evolution. And maybe this is cheating a little bit, because I don't know his other releases all that great, all that well, but this one is phenomenal. I love this album. So pretty avant-garde. On here you have just an incredible lineup. So Lee Morgan on trumpet, Jackie McLean on alto sax, of course Great Jim Moncur III on trombone, Bobby Hutcherson on vibraphone, Bob Crenshaw on bass and Anthony Williams on the drums. Just a terrific album. This copy is actually a 75th anniversary release. Now, out of all the 75th anniversary releases from Blue Note that I have, this pressing isn't as good as the others. You hear a lot of people complain about these pressings, and this one does suffer. So I need to upgrade this at some point. But just, this is an all-time classic. Love this album. Okay, next. Favorite record you bought in a brick and mortar shop? Okay, so again, too many favorites to pick one, but what I decided to do is show an album that Chris, Tunes from the Man Cave, actually put in my hands when we went digging in June of 2019. We were at Tip Top Market and the Premium Sound record store that's right off of the market. And he found this for me, Home Cookin', The Incredible Jimmy Smith, with Percy France, Kenny Burrell, and Donald Bailey on Blue Note. So this was a great score. This came out in 1961, I believe, and this is a 1962 pressing. So Jimmy Smith on the organ, Percy France on tenor sax, Kenny Burrell on guitar, and then Donald Bailey on drums. So, great one. Thank you, Chris, for finding that one for me while we were digging. Okay, record you bought online. So I could have picked tons of... I could have had my choice of what to pick because I have bought a lot online. Although my, you know, obviously the preferred way is to go in the store and dig for records, but I have bought plenty online. And this is one of them. This is Mal Waldron, Mal 2. Originally came out in 1957 on Prestige. And this is a Japanese release from 1976. Another great one. Big fan of Mal Waldron. And this has, I'll just stop after Mal Waldron, Jackie McLean, and John Coltrane. That'll give you a hint of what this is like. So then you have Idris Suleiman, Sahib Shihab, and Bill Hardman. Great, great album. So I think this was a Discogs buy a few years ago. And it's another one of my favorite albums. Okay, next, moving along here. Record a friend found for you or gifted you. So I've been on the receiving end of a lot of generosity in the vinyl community. Received a lot of gifts, VCLT. So I could have showed a lot, but... this is Grant Green, Green Street on Music Matters. And this was gifted to me by Paul over at Baraka P-Dub. Incredibly generous. And this wasn't the only thing he gifted me. He gave me a few other albums as well. But one of Grant's best. And... just a great gift from Paul. So thank you again, Paul. Incredibly generous of you, and I cherish this album because you gifted it to me. So, and I don't want to shortchange anyone else that has gifted me anything, but I can't show them all. But this is one jazz album that I was gifted, and I love it. Oh, so on here you have, of course, Grant Green on guitar, Ben Tucker on bass, and Dave Bailey on drums. And just a great recording. Okay, next one. This is a fun question. Or the next two. Oh, I skipped one. Okay. Jazz box set. So I've shown this a handful of times on here, but here is John Coltrane, 1963, New Directions. This, first of all, awesome box set. It's pretty much everything Coltrane recorded in 1963. Five LPs, and it's just great. So this actually came via Mazzy through a contest that he had. I don't even remember what the contest was at this point, but this was a prize. He handpicked a box set to send out to the winner. I don't know if there's multiple winners. I can't remember, but I was a winner, and this is what he sent me, and I love it, and it's incredible. So, John Coltrane, 1963, New Directions. Thank you again, Mazzy, for this generous prize. Okay, now this one is the fun question, I thought. Jazz 10-inch or 7-inch? I'm going to show both. First is 10-inch. This is Blue Note Miles Davis, Volume 2, Young Man with a Horn. Very cool to have this. Obviously the cover has a lot of wear on it, but the vinyl is nice, plays pretty good. This is from 1952, I think. Would love to get Volume 1, but haven't come across it yet, so was really excited to pick this up and have it. Must have gotten it in, I think I got it in 2018, so a few years ago. But very, very cool. Okay, on here you have Miles Davis on trumpet, obviously. J.J. Johnson on trombone, Jimmy Heath on bass, and Art Blakey on the drums. So a pretty cool 10-inch. Now, 7-inch. This actually came out of my uncle's collection. He knew I was collecting records, and he let me go through. Actually, he just kind of gave everything to me. Not much that I really wanted out of that collection, but there was a few gems, and this is one of them. It is Getz Gilberto, The Girl from Ipanema, from the album Getz Gilberto, and this is on Verve. And on the other side is Stan Getz and his cover of Dylan's Blowin' in the Wind. So, pretty cool there. Moving along here. Most recent jazz score. Going back to Benny Green. Benny Green, Hornful of Soul. This came out in 1961. This is a 1965 repress, I guess, on Bethlehem. This is a recent pickup. So, I'm realizing that I'm showing a lot of trombone in this vinyl tag. So Benny Green, so on here you have Benny Green on trombone, Lem Davis on alto sax, Jimmy Forrest on tenor sax, Skip Hall on organ, Mal Waldron on piano, Tommy Lopez on conga, R. Taylor on drums, and Wyatt Ruther on bass. So, Benny Green. Okay, next question. Jazz record you hope to find in 2021? One record I would love to find. I mean, I have a lot, but if I'm picking one, I'm going to go with Tony Williams' Lifetime. Dave, again, over at Local Bandography, just did a great review of that album in the Blue Note 4000 series. As a matter of fact, I'll link that video down below and you can check it out. But that is one that I would love to find this year. Jazz record you own that you'd like to upgrade in 2021. So this is a Golden Flute, Yusuf Lateef. First thing, the jacket's got some obnoxious writing on it. Inside's pretty good, but this is noisy. This has a lot of, I don't know if it'll come through, but it's got a lot of scuffing on it, and it's pretty noisy. I don't think it's coming way there. I don't know if you can see that. So I'd like to get an upgrade of this one. This is definitely playable, but yeah, need an upgrade. But I found this pretty cheap at a local shop here. A couple years ago, I think. All right. Winding down here. Show a free jazz record. I don't have too much free jazz, but I do have some. And this is one that I return to pretty often, and it's Ornette Coleman, Science Fiction. This came out in 1972 on Columbia. And yeah, I really like this one. Let's see. Too many names on here, but people like Ed Blackwell on drums, Billy Higgins on drums, Dewey Redman on sax, Don Cherry on trumpet, Charlie Hayden on bass. Those guys are on a bunch of these tracks, but Free Jazz, Science Fiction, 1972 from Ornette Coleman. The cover is a little beat, but this plays great. It's even got a little split there. I got this at a store that's not around anymore. That used to be my most local store. He closed at the end of 2019, and I got this for $2, and this is a great pickup because the album's great, and it's one that I return to pretty frequently. Okay, and the final question of the Jazz Vinyl Tag 2021. And that is Desert Island Jazz Album. And this was going to be the one I was going to show for favorite album of discography, of an artist's discography. And it is Search for the New Land, Lee Morgan. What an amazing album this is. This is one of my top favorite albums, jazz albums. So Lee Morgan on trumpet, Wayne Shorter on tenor sax, Grant Green on guitar, Herbie Hancock on piano, Reggie Workman on bass, and Billy Higgins on drums. Just an incredible lineup. The title track is just an amazing song, and I really love it. And this is this would be a Desert Island pick, although I have many others. This is definitely one of them. So that is the Jazz Vinyl Tag 2021. thanks for sticking through this and going through the questions with me. Chris, thank you so much for putting this together. This was a lot of fun to think about and go through the collection. And I'm hoping we can hook up again next time I'm down in Charlotte. So I'll hit you up. But everyone, that's going to do it. Thank you so much for watching. Hope everybody's doing well, and I will talk to you all again soon. Bye.